Hey everyone! So I'm back with another journal with me video. Hopefully this one will be straight to the point and a little less talky-talky like the last one. Again, I'm gonna do a page in this little junk art journal scrap thing that I have here in my A6. Traveler's notebook. So I just took out the insert and I'm gonna move this aside and I'm gonna find a page. I guess the back of this one, and I guess I'll do two, like the two, but I already have an idea of what I want to do. Since this is copy paper, this is just like regular copy paper, that's how I made these little booklets. It's regular copy paper that I tea dyed, so of course it's been wet like numerous times. And then doing this, I did watercolor, so the watercolor of course went through, and kind of want to cover that, but at the same time I kind of want to do another tape transfer so that you can see it like properly and not like the last time. So I'm gonna get some things. I have a box. I like bought one of those really pretty decorative boxes from Michaels, and it's a huge box, and it's where I keep all of my art journaling stuff. So I keep my art journaling stuff separate from like scrapbooking stuff. I had a smaller box for it, but this one is nice because it holds all of my kind of my catalogs. This, of course, might be like a completely separate video. I might do a video of where I find my images from, like the images that I use to art journal. If you've seen any of my other art journal, my specific art journal videos, you would know I do a lot of image transfers, and I use a lot of model photos from magazines. And I get those model photos from a lot of places. So I have a box full of little clippings from magazines and catalogs, but it also carries my like giant catalog thing. But that might be a completely different video, and I totally might do that if you're interested in knowing where I find my images from, like in magazines and stuff like that. I can definitely do that video. But I'm gonna go get a few of the little baggies that I have and pick out a few images from that box. So I have my images. I have them in like little bags. These are just those bags you get like when you order stuff from like scrapbook.com and A Cherry on Top. You know, they come in like bag things. So I have them, I sort of have a system. This is kind of where all the book paper would go. Like, so these are scraps that I just have here. So they will eventually go in here once I'm done with them and I have leftovers. These are magazine clippings. These are specific. These are different papers and patterns. So technically this one should be in here, but so here I just have like just different patterns of and things. It's kind of like texture patterns and stuff like that. So that's what I keep in this bag. But I think what I want for this spread here is this image right here. So this is where I keep all of like the model images, and like most of these are illustrations, and I can tell you right now that most of these illustrations I got from, I think, a Nylon magazine. I used to get a lot of Nylon magazines. I used to be subscribed to it like way back in like maybe 2014, and I had a year's worth of Nylon magazines like stacked in my room. I recently got rid of them, but before I did, I looked through all of them and tore out a bunch of stuff. So a lot of these kind of illustrations of girls, of course, I got from those magazines. And then others, like I think the magazine's called Wonderland. It's a UK magazine, I think, that I picked up randomly. I think I picked it up because it had Emma Watson on the cover and it was pretty. And so I spent a lot of money on it. I eventually tore out a bunch of things and threw it out, but you know. Anyway, I'm like completely ranting, and I said this was gonna be straightforward. This will be another video, I promise. So I think I'm gonna use that, and I don't know what else I wanna use. So I'm just gonna use that for now. And my initial thought was to put it here and do an image transfer using gel medium. But I don't know how that would react with this paper, since it's like, and I don't wanna prime it first. Like, I basically am really lazy and don't want to take out the gesso to prime it or anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do another image transfer, but with the packing tape so we can see it better. Because last time I talked a lot before I actually made it to the packing tape transfer. Now, where's the end of this tape? So let me like explain what you would need. But basically what you need is your laser printed images, packing tape, and a container of water, and maybe like a paper towel to scrub off the water. You want laser printed images. I think I kind of went over why in the last video, but again, I talked a lot, so I'm just gonna go over it now again. Laser printed images they use toner, which does not react to water. Unlike inkjet, when you print something off an inkjet, if you put water on it, it'll smudge because it's a dye ink base. This is toner. So anything that's printed publication-wise would most likely be printed with toner because it lasts longer because it's water resistant. Well, the ink is, not the paper, but you know. So you want something that's printed with toner, which is ink, which is laser printed. If you get images from the internet, you might want to take it, if you don't have a laser printer, take it to like, what is it, like FedEx, Kinko's, or you know, like one of those printing service places, because they all have laser printers, and that's usually their main printers are laser printers, and you can just get a bunch of things laser printed, because that's how you can do image transfers. And this goes for any type of image transfer. So packing tape image transfer, acetone transfers, or gel medium transfers, any type of image transfer, it has to be laser printed images printed using toner ink. So this is my image, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut strips, let me just say it first, cut strips of the tape and tape over the image. Now you wanna make sure that there are no bubbles, that the tape goes on flat, and what we're gonna do is layer the tape over each other. The last time I made the mistake of putting the other piece of tape right at the edge of the other tape, we don't wanna do that. We wanna layer the tape on top of each other. Let's hope I have enough tape for this transfer. And of course, I would run out of tape. I don't think I have any more packing tape too in the house either. So let's see. So I managed to salvage some tape for at least this side. This side's gonna be a bit messy since that tape was a bit gross. The white part is not gonna transfer unless there's ink on it. So I'm just gonna cut off some of that excess, like all this here. Cause it's not gonna transfer anyway. Have these weird lines only because that was the end of my packing tape. I would have to go get more packing tape, but that's basically what you do. You cover the entire thing with packing tape, like on the top of it, and make sure that the tape is overlapped and everything. And now this is where the water comes in. I should have got a bigger bowl of water, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna submerge the entire image, the entire paper into the water, and you're gonna begin to scrape off the back. So just gonna do that now, and you can already see it, how the image, the magazine paper takes to the water. You want that water to absorb into the paper because then it'll be much easier to scrape off the back. You can see it when you have it in the water. You can see how it's getting like kind of bubbly looking. You want that to soak in there so that that paper gets really, really moist. And then, you know, while it's in the water, you can begin just kind of rubbing the back, and you know how paper, it kind of disintegrates. Well, when you keep rubbing it, you'll get like, you'll feel the little particles coming apart, and it'll create some sort of like friction, and then you just keep rubbing. You're just gonna have to keep rubbing it until all of that back paper comes off. So you see how that back is starting to come off? I'm gonna take all that backing off. And the lovely thing about it is that the image that stays is the image that was on the front. Now you see how the ink on that image didn't really set in as much? You can stop rubbing it now. And maybe let the ink settle a little bit, or you can just keep rubbing it. It'll just be a light transfer. But you see how this is the tape? This is the tape without no paper on the back. And it's kind of like, you can see the image on that. It's pretty cool. How nice and smooth that came off. See that? All right, so I mean, you can still feel it to see if there are any like paper stuck, but I think mine is pretty good. All the paper is like in there. So I'm gonna actually place it down here. Do you see how it's translucent, and then once you put it down, you see the image? Look at that. Super cool. You can actually let this dry, and depending what type of packing tape you used, the backing, which is this, part of it will get sticky, so you don't even have to like glue it down or anything, because the back will become like a little bit sticky again. And you can just put it down anywhere and the image will pop up. See, it's already drying and it's already becoming a little bit sticky. But I love that. What you can do is too, I mean, I'm gonna put mine down on the paper, but what you can do is you can maybe put this on a bit of acetate, which is the clear transparency, and you make your own transparencies. That'd be really cool. I actually did that before in a different, I think it was an art journal. Yeah, so I have that. That is my image of the girl. And of course, that coloring from the other page is going to peek through. It's going to peek through. I'm not sure yet if I want to do anything about the back. If I want to put some white paint to make that a little lighter, or if I want that paint to peek through. Kind of makes it look like she has like freckles or something. But yeah, I'm just putting it down on my page, and since the tape is a bit sticky, it's just gonna stick right onto the page like that. And I love it how the image, since it's on the tape, it goes over this other paper here. But yeah, I think I'm gonna leave it like that. You can see a bit of that green on her forehead, and you can see the pink paint splatters. Which were these guys, you know, that is coming through, but it looks very artsy and it looks very cute. And you notice how the white did not transfer because there's no ink there. Only thing that transferred were the flowers. So I actually really, really love how this looked. Like, you can see the lines of the tape too, because I had to, like, you know, jigsaw puzzle tape. But I love how that looks. It looks distressed. It looks really, really cool. And so now I can just embellish on top. I can do my journaling here. I actually don't know what I want to do. I took out some tape. These are both polka dot tapes. They're fabric tapes to give it a bit more texture. The colors kind of match. So I don't know if I want to put some tape here, like that, or what. I really don't know. You know what? I think I might just leave it like it is. Just like that. Yeah, I might just leave it just like that. Too bad I don't have any more tape. I would do like, another tape transfer over it, because that's what you can do. Once you have a base layer of the tape transfer, you can actually go ahead and take more packing tape and do another tape transfer, and then once that is all rubbed and everything, you can put that transfer right on top. And so you're kind of building up the layers, and it's just layers of packing tape transfers. So I think I'm gonna leave that like that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave it like that. I might actually go and get some word phrase stickers and just put something here, and then I'll do my journaling here. So I went ahead and got my stamp, and I got my little pouch that has a few word phrase stickers. These that I'm taking out are all from Simple Stories. They're from the Carpe Diem planner line. I think some of them are from the planner line, the last year's planner line, and then some of them are this year's planner line. Like, I think these are, because these are the Reset Girl. So, or these guys came out last year for 2017. These came out in 2015 for 2016. But I have a bunch of them because these are my favorite. I use these word phrase stickers for everything. You can see them all in my planners, in my memory planners. Any little journal type thing, I love using these stickers. I actually use them for this page here. Those are some stickers. I just love them so much. I love any type of phrase sticker, to be quite honest. Like, the new Maggie Holmes Chasing Dreams came out. She came out with a thing, was half labels and half phrase stickers with like foil on them. I love those. I have two of them. I bought one for myself, and then one came in my hip kits. So I was just like, yes, I love those. Crate Paper also did them for, I think, Craft Market. Their line called Craft Market. It was half white and half craft. I love those too. I wish I bought two of those. I only bought one, and it's mostly used up, because I use them a lot in my travel journals, like the journals I take with me when I go on my trips. They're awesome. They're just awesome to put little sentiments. But Simple Stories, I have a ton of them. And I think I want to use the off-white ones instead of the white ones. The Reset Girl ones are fun too, because they have, it's like a grid, and then it has these paint splatters. or these, but I think I like these. And I don't even know what I want it to say. Just something. Let me see. Because there's so many. Like, there's literally so many of them. So, I think since today is Friday, and that's when I'm filming this, I'm gonna use this sticker. It says I Heart Fridays. And then I'm gonna use this sticker. It says currently. With a colon. And then it says currently I Heart Fridays. And then I'm gonna take my stamp and get the date. Just the 10th. And I don't know if I want to put the date here. I think I'm going to put the date there so that I can journal over here. And I'm a terrible stamper. I absolutely suck at stamping, so we'll see how this goes here. Cool. Because it is the 10th. And I think that is going to be my spread. I am gonna go ahead and do some journaling over here off camera. And I think that's it. So I hope you enjoyed this Journal With Me video. I hope the image transfer with the packing tape was a lot more clear in this video, because it wasn't as rushed and I wasn't talking about nonsense before, even though I wasn't really talking about nonsense in the other video. It's just, you know, I was talking a lot just about the whole change of process, and I really just didn't give the technique justice. And so hopefully this video clears that up. It's gonna be part two, or take two, of the image transfer with the packing tape. I think it came out great. The first one came out great. This one came out better, I think. It also has to do with the image that you use too, but it's kind of cool. I love, and you never know, like each paper reacts to the water differently, and depending what kind of toner, ink, everything reacts differently, so you never know what you're gonna get with an image transfer. Hopefully, since today is Friday, I don't really film on the weekends, but hopefully next week I'll have a video up, or maybe once this video is posted, so it'll be kind of later in the week. So when you're seeing it, it's gonna be Monday. You're seeing this video, it's Monday, but I filmed this on Friday. So later in the week, I might have a video where I do a image transfer with gel medium. Of course, this is all dependent on whether or not I want to clean up a mess, because that one is really messy, and I've learned to embrace clean journaling. So a lot of collage, a lot of maybe watercolor paints. My art journals usually, on them for the most part, are heavy based with acrylic and acrylic mediums and stuff like that, but sometimes when I would set up and do art journaling, I just didn't want to clean up because it was just too much. So that's why you don't really see much here. It's all paper, which is easy to clean up. Of course, I have this tub of water, but I can just dump it, and that's basically it. So we'll see. We'll see if I'm up to cleaning art supplies. I'll do a little transfer video. And if not, I will think of something else to show you. I don't know. Yet. I never know what I want to do on a page until I kind of sit down and look at the page and think. Like last night I was actually looking at this page after I did this, and I knew I wanted to use this cutout because I was organizing my cutouts. I'm like, oh, that would look great with this because the colors work. And I already had the idea, so that's why coming on today and doing it was easy peasy because I already had the idea. But sometimes, like, I'm looking at this now and I'm just like, what can I do here? And I think that's the challenge with a journal like this that you make, and it has all these different textures and different bits already in it. See, like, this is already layered. This is already a layered page. But to, like, put things on top and behind it, this already has little things to pull out. Like, these journals, these kind of junky set, like, styled journals, they already have little bits in it already. So when you go into journal, you can easily just do your writing, doing your journal there, and you have a spread. But you know, sometimes you want to cover it up, you want to do little fun things like this one. This is the one that I did on that long video. I did my journaling on the back, and so it's like interactive, you pull it out. I left the vellum alone because I think it's pretty. And then over here I did watercoloring. Didn't really do much written journaling, this is more like an art journal page. Here I'll do like a little journaling here. But yeah, that's the challenge with this little book, or these types of little books, is that the pages, some of them are already like done for you in terms of, you know, decorations and stuff like that. So like this one's pretty blank, so you can build on top of this. But like things that have little things here, or like I said, that other one, or the ones that have like tags already in the pockets, and stuff like that, those are a bit more, you know, challenging to do anything art journaling wise, if that makes sense. But yeah, this is interesting. It's a very different departure from my normal art journal, and I'm excited to see how this little book turns out. Anyway, I think I've spoken too much already, and I will leave you here. Thank you again for watching, and like always, give it a thumbs up if you like, subscribe, and I will see you all next video. Bye.